Hey there, fellow game devs, and welcome back to Soul's Game Dev Journey. In our previous episode, we've set up Cinemachine to make our camera movement more dynamic and interesting. We also have a powerful tool at our disposal for future improvements. The focus of this video will be on how we can handle grid interactions through a fairly simple setup. I will not go too crazy with our implementation. Instead, we will be setting a good foundation that's neither too simple but rigid, nor is it an overdesign for what we need at the moment. So, let's get into it. If you've completed any at least intermediate programming course, you should be familiar with finite state machines. Here's a quick overview. Finite state machine represents states and transitions between them. There are two key states, initial and final, though final state may be optional. Usually, of course, there will be many more states in between. In a complete implementation of a finite state machine, we would define state, which would have transitions to other states. There would also be events, which would trigger these transitions, and actions which determine the behavior of the system when it's in that state. The implementation we're looking into today will be a very simple version of a finite state machine. If you need to, you can take it as a base and expand on it, or make it even simpler. Let's first have a look at what we're trying to achieve. I want to have five states: hidden, visible, highlighted, selected, and focused. Hidden state will be the initial state of the tile. At this moment, this will simply mean it will be deactivated, but I will probably make a different prefab for those tiles in the future. The tile in hidden state can transition into visible state. At the moment, I will determine some starting tiles in a radius, but later a player will discover the tiles by moving around the map. From the visible state, the tile can transition to highlighted state if the mouse pointer is over it. From the highlighted state, the tile can transition back to visible if we've moved the mouse away, or to selected if we've triggered select action. From selected state, we can move to focus state if we triggered focus action, or we can move back to visible if we've deselected the tile. And finally, from the focused state, we can transition back to the selected state. These are all the interactions I will look into for now. As you can see, it's a good start. It will allow us to do a few different things, but at the same time isn't overly complicated, so you could take a fairly simplistic approach with this as well. But we want to be flexible and also learn a bit more than just a hacky single script approach. So, let's have a look at the main parts of our code. We're mostly concerned about the state. Our structure will be as follows: an enum called cell state, which will have the names of different states I've mentioned before. This will be useful for quick checks and serialization later down the line. Secondly, we will have an interface called an iCellState, which will have a cell state property called state, two methods for enter and exit, which will take the hex cell information so they can perform actions. And we will also have all the possible events the state may want to know about to trigger a transition. This allows us to perform an action when we enter a new state and when we exit it. We could also add a stay or active method to perform actions continuously when in a state. The events equally represent only what I could currently think of and you could and more possible events to trigger transitions from. Both the actions performed at different stages of state's transition and transition events could be further abstracted into their own classes, even into scriptable objects, to be reusable and so that you could easily swap them in the inspector. Moving along, we have an abstract class called baseCellState which implements the interface. All actual states will inherit from this class. In this class, we provide some basic setup, such as forcing us to implement the state getter, enter, and exit methods, while it provides a default implementation for the transition events, which are all set to not transition and stay in the same state by default. This way, we don't have to repeat ourselves in concrete state classes, and are forced to implement key methods, making us less likely to miss something. Now, we can have a look at concrete implementation of different states. At the most basic, we have the hidden state. This just implements the getter, which unsurprisingly returns hidden, and on entering the state we hide the game object if it exits, and on exit we activate it again. The transitions for this one are currently not defined and will be implemented when we can move from tile to tile. Visible state looks similar, but makes sure the terrain is active and doesn't do anything on exit. It does implement a transition on mouse enter, which will transition the hex cell into the highlighted state. For highlighted state, I've decided to move the cell up a bit, for now. This is not a permanent solution, but it works for the demonstration. If you want to do the same, you'll need to import the lean tween package from the asset store. It's free, powerful, and simple, so I suggest you try it out. There are two transitions here: on mouse exit leads back to the visible state, and on select leads to selected state. In the selected state, I don't do much visually, but subscribe and unsubscribe to the events in camera controller and lock the movement of the camera. We will get to changes in the camera controller later. Again, we have two transitions on deselect and on focus. These were subscribed to the camera controller events on enter. And finally, the focus state. It's similar to the selected state in that it subscribes to the deselect event in CameraController and locks the movement. It of course also changes the camera mode. On the deselect event, it transitions back to selected state. There we go, this covers all the current states. Now let's have a look at what we need to do in Hex Cell class. First I've put in properties for the state, so that we know what state we're in. I've also put in an initialize state and change state methods. Then I have all the possible transition events which just call the change state with the result of the transition function of the state class. I've made some changes to create terrain method which are specific to my setup of prefab. The point of the changes is that I needed a way to register on mouse enter and on mouse exit events. If you have a simple prefab you don't have a problem, but in my case, I have to disable colliders of children so they don't interfere with mouse events. The easiest solution I've found was to create a mini script called HexTerrain which is responsible to setting collider behavior properly. In the HexGrid I wanted a way to decide which tiles will be seen, so I've added default visible cells list, where I can put in the offset coordinates of the cells I want to make visible as well as a default visible radius, to know the radius around those cells that should be visible. A new set visible cells method, which is subscribed to the onCell instances generated event, will be responsible to use that information to forcefully change state. In the future, I will most likely add a discover method to the cell and make change state method private. Another addition to the hex cell is that we call setNeighbors method at the end of the generate hex cell data. This method goes through all the cells, gets the coordinates of the neighbors, finds them, and if they exist, adds them to the list of neighbors for that cell. As you can see, I've expanded the HexMetrics class for this with a getNeighborCoordinates list, which simply returns a list of axial coordinates of all the possible neighbors in a hex grid. Finally, let's have a look at the changes in the camera controller. The script no longer changes the mode itself. Instead, events are triggered to which other scripts can respond to. Change camera method has therefore been made public. I've also added a locking functionality so that the player can't move the camera around when the tile is selected or focused. For this to work, I simply had to check the isLocked flag in the onPanChange method and exit if it's true. There will now also be a deselect action, which is very simple. It simply calls the onDeselectAction event when the action is performed. This also means we will need to add it into our input map. If you want to know more about that, check my previous video, which covers the creation of player input, defining actions and bindings, etc. These are the main changes we needed to introduce states to the grid. The final result is what you can see on the screen. Most tiles are hidden, some tiles are visible, and it's all set in the inspector. If I hover the mouse over a visible tile, it'll move up, indicating it's highlighted. If I trigger select action, I'll move the camera target to its location, and if I then focus the tile, I'll move into focus mode of the camera. With the deselect action, I can then move first out of focus state, and then out of the selected state. This is it for today's video. I hope you've learned a bit about interactions and how to manage states in a bit cleaner way than with one massive script and an enum or even just flags to keep the track of the states. There's of course room for expansion. If you have any questions, leave them below or join our Discord server. You can check the code on my GitHub repository.